G'day, it's Paul here, and I'm sitting out in a quarry near Victor Harbour that's owned by Genesis Transport. And they've been very kind to us and they've lent us a vehicle. Just so good. But we're talking about stones today, the living stone and a chosen people. As you come to him, the living stone, this is from 1 Peter 2, from verse 4 through to verse 10. It's called the living stone and a chosen people. From verse 4, as you come to him, the living stone, rejected by humans but chosen by God and precious to him, you are also like living stones are being built into a spiritual house to be a holy priesthood, offering spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For in Scripture it says, see, I lay a stone in Zion, a chosen and precious cornerstone, and the one who trusts in him will never be put to shame. He's talking about Jesus, the rock, the stone in Zion. Now to you who believe that this stone is precious, but to those who do not believe, the stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone, and a stone that causes people to stumble and a rock that makes them fall. They stumble because they disobey the message, which is also what they were destined for. But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. Once you were not a people, but now you are the people of God. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy. So there we are. We trust in the cornerstone. We trust in the stone that the builders rejected, because that stone is the rock called Jesus Christ. He is our Lord. He's our Saviour. He is our Redeemer, who gave his life for us, that we may be reconciled to God the Father. You get into the Word. Let the Word of God get into you. From the quarry in Victor Harbour, God bless you. We'll see you later now. Bye.